Hello everyone, I am back from a brief hiatus. I've been away mainly on an artist retreat, and I've also had a lot of real life stuff that I've been dealing with on the side, so a lot of my free time has been dedicated towards that. I'll just leave that area of life alone for right now and get to the video. But I want to thank all of my subscribers and those who have kept up with me and continued commenting, and those who really show a lot of interest in my 3D models and stuff like that. You guys are amazing, and I love that I can share in the 3D modeling community and the artist community all together. It really makes me happy that I can change people's perspectives and change people's lives and add to them. So, a lot of the Google SketchUp models are beautiful and really sharpened and nice, but I've come to find out recently, well, not recently, I've kind of always knew about this, but I just never really transferred over because I was so addicted to Google SketchUp. But my models are not necessarily the best models to be using. And I say this wholeheartedly because, yeah, they may look nice, they may look colored and somewhat textured, if you will, or improvised texturing, if you will, for lack of a better term. But my models are Google SketchUp models. They're not 3DS made models, they're not Lightwave made models, they're not Maya made models, and because of that, I'm very limited as to what I can do with these models. So, as a result of that, I've started training myself and working in 3ds Max a little bit. And if there is not a plethora of Google SketchUp videos coming your way, there's going to be a start of new series with 3ds Max. So, I want to forewarn you guys about that. And just another heads up, I am going to be going through a move soon, so my ability to put out videos and content will be rather on and off, sporadic throughout the summer. And when school starts again, I may or may not go into another hiatus. It all depends on how much time I'm going to have available to me. So I just want to forewarn you guys about that. And without further ado, I'll continue on with this video. And there's going to be another little snippet here of what I'm going to be doing with this model in particular, and we'll go on from there. For this model, it was made a while back. This is when my flash drive got screwed up, and I had to restart from scratch pretty much for everything. Almost, and when I did that, I wanted to go from the bottom of the ship class all the way up. So fighters, interceptors, bombers, dropships, corvettes, and then I get into frigates, cruisers, battleships, destroyers, blah 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 blah. So with this one, I didn't put a lot of effort into it because it was mainly just a filler model because I hadn't had anything for corvettes. I really hadn't thought about that because if you haven't figured it out already, I'm more of a capital ship type of person, so I love building cruisers and stuff like that, big ships, because I love slugfests when it comes to like sci-fi and stuff like that. Battlestar Galactica was definitely one of those ones that really influenced me with that. Halo definitely as well. So the Corvette class was really wasn't a main focus of mine. And as I'm coming back to it, I think it's a really good ship to start off with as I'm coming back from the hiatus because it'll allow me to refresh in my skills and everything, get them built up to where I want them to be, and it'll also help me get in the mode, just get in the mode of thinking about how a lot of these models and stuff would fit into the big picture in a futuristic civilization that's spacefaring. So with the transport corvette, I thought, okay, it would be really cool if we had a multi-purpose type ship that could be used for military and civilian people. And that could transport large quantities of equipment, troops, and stuff to and from the planets. And the idea came that this ship would be perfect for that because when colonizing new planets, stuff like that, there won't necessarily be an orbital elevator to transport equipment and personnel to and from the planet. So you'll need something to drop that kind of equipment down, or at least start something. So for the civilian side, prefabricated drilling sites, drilling equipment, habitation modules, people, all kinds of equipment, solar panels, stuff of that nature, anything that a starter colony would need, a transport corvette could carry and take it down to the surface. And then for the military, it could carry entire garrison bases, thousands of troops, equipment, tanks, anything that could start off a miniature army or military presence on a new world or on a world that they're attacking, and there needs to be a location that needs to be a base. So, okay, we'll drop a prefab base through a transport corvette, and there you have it. There isn't any. There isn't that long time period in between transporting equipment and personnel by smaller means like drop ships and stuff like that. And eventually they'll have a base up. No, we'll have a prefabricated base put into this transport corvette, drop that sucker in the middle of nowhere, and there we go. Military has a base ready to go. And it would be an awesome ship to have in like your Titan or your carrier, stuff like that, because I imagine carriers, I think, almost like in the terms of Halo, where they had large sums of military equipment, vehicles, transport, stuff of that nature, and they're able to deploy large forces on planets while also being able to provide large quantities of fighters and stuff for space battles and act as command ships and stuff too sometimes. So that's really the conceptualization, I guess, of that. I don't even think that's a word, but that's the whole concept of this ship and where I'm going. And I'm taking aspects of an old model that I did for a little video game group that unfortunately was unsuccessful with what they were trying to do, and I'm implementing that into this model. So you'll definitely see that, and I think I may do a little showcase video of some of those other models that I did for another group in some YouTube videos. But yeah, that's pretty much my mentality behind this, and you'll see that kind of come into fruition here. This is going to be a part series as well because I didn't finish the model yet. I'm still going through the twists and turns of getting back into the mojo of Google SketchUp, so I didn't get to finish this one in one straight get-go. So enjoy.
Take no more. Thank you. tick, 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 tick. Tick, tick, tick.
Tick, 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 tick.